Hey, my name is Felipe and welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to train an object detector on your own custom data using Yolov8 and Google Colab. And this is the notebook we are going to use in order to train this object detector. And you can see that this notebook is comprised of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 steps. So in only 5 steps, you will have your own object detector up and running. And this notebook will be available in the GitHub repository of today's tutorial. But now let me show you something else, because we are going to use Google Colab, but we're also going to use Google Drive. And this is a directory I have created in my Google Drive in order to work on this project. And you can see that this directory is located in my Drive, Computer Vision Engineer, Object Detection, Yolov8, Google Colab. This is a directory I am going to use in order to upload all the data and all the files we need in order to work on this project. So the first step you will need to take is to create a directory in your Google Drive. Now let's continue. And now let me show you the data we are going to use in order to train this object detector. And you can see that these are many pictures of squirrels. So this is the dataset I am going to use. I am going to train an object detector to detect squirrels, but obviously you can use whatever dataset you want in order to train this object detector. Now let me show you something which is very important, and it's exactly how you need to prepare the data and how you need to structure the data in order to train this object detector. This is a very important step, so please pay attention. If I go here, you can see I have a directory which is called data. This is the root directory of my data, and if I open this directory, you can see I have two additional directories. One of them is called images and the other one is called labels. If I open images, you can see I have two additional directories. One of them is called train and the other one is called val. And if I open train, this is where all my training images are located. So these are the images I am going to use in order to train the object detector. If I go back and if I open the val directory, these are all the images I am going to use as validation data. These are the images I am going to use in order to validate the object detector. So, now let's go back and now let me show you what's in this directory, which is called labels. You can see I also have two additional directories. One of them is also called train, the other one is also called ball. And if I open train, these are all the labels, all the annotations of the training data, of the training images. If I open the val directory, these are all the labels, all the annotations of the validation data. So it's very important you structure the data exactly like this. You need a root directory, then within this directory you have two additional directories. One of them is called images and the other one is called labels, and it's very important these two directories are called exactly like this. One of them should be called images and the other one should be called labels. It's very important you name these directories exactly like this. Then within images you will have two additional directories. One of them should be called train and the other one should be called val. It's very important you name these directories exactly like this, and then within these two directories is where you will locate all of your data, all the training data and all the validation data. And then for the labels it's exactly the same. You need two directories. One of them should be called train and the other one should be called val. It's very important you name these directories exactly like this, and then this is where you're going to locate all your labels, all your annotations, all the training labels and all the validation labels. So please pay attention, because it's very important you structure the data exactly like this, otherwise it's not going to work. So please make sure you have structured data into exactly this format, and once you are sure everything complies with this format, then you are ready to continue. Then the only thing you need to do is to upload this data into your Google Drive. So once everything complies with the format I show you, the only thing you need to do is to take this directory and to drag and drop this directory into your Google Drive, and that's pretty much all. And then you just need to wait until the uploading is completed, and that's pretty much all. Now let me show you something else, which is the dataset I used in order to download all the images of all the squirrels I am going to use in this video. All these images I showed you a few minutes ago, and also all the annotations I am going to use in order to train this object detector, and it's the Google Open Images dataset version 7. This is an amazing dataset, and I definitely recommend you to take a look at this dataset, because you are going to find many different images, many different categories, many different type of annotations. You have bounding boxes for object detection, you also have masks for semantic segmentation, and this is an amazing dataset. I have used it many times in my projects, and this is exactly the dataset from which I have downloaded all the images and all the annotations of squirrels. So this is an amazing dataset, and I recommend you take a look at this website. And I also created a Python script and a video with very detailed instructions on how you can download data from this dataset. And I try super hard to make this process super simple, to make all this downloading process super simple. So by just following the instructions I provide in that video, and by using that script, you will be able to create whatever object detection dataset you want. You can just download images from all the categories you want, and you can just create your dataset in only a few minutes. And this is an amazing resource I created in order to help you to train your object detection models, and this is a resource which is available in my Patreon. So it's going to be available to all my Patreon supporters. Now let's continue. Now let me show you how to execute all the steps in this process and how to train this object detector. And the only thing we need to do now is to execute all the cells in this notebook one at a time, and that's going to be pretty much all. The first cell is the one that's going to connect your Google Drive with Google Colab, and this is very important, because remember, you will need to access all the data in your Google Drive, right? So you need to select your account, then you're going to scroll all the way down and you're going to click Allow. And that's pretty much all. Now Google Drive is mounted in your Google Colab environment. That's pretty much all. Everything is ready, so we can continue. Now the next step is defining this variable, which is root directory. And this is the directory of your project in your Google Drive, right? Remember, in my case, I'm uploading all the files and all the data and so on into this directory of my Google Drive. So this is something you will need to change to the directory you have created in your Google Drive. Remember, in my case, everything is located in my drive: Computer Vision Engineer, Object Detection, Yolov8, Google Colab. And if I show you this variable, this is what we have over here: my drive, Computer Vision Engineer, and then Object Detection, Yolov8, Google Colab. And then, as everything is mounted here on Content G Drive, you can see that everything is located in Content G Drive, and then it's the location of my directory on my Google Colab. So please make sure you change this variable to whatever location you have uploaded all of your data, and whatever location you have chosen for your directory in your Google Drive. This is very important, and once you have changed this variable, the only thing you need to do is to execute this cell, and that's it. Then this cell over here is going to install Ultralytics, which is the Python library you need in order to train Yolov8 on your custom dataset, and this is very straightforward. The only thing you need to do is to execute this cell, and that's it. Now if I scroll down, we are almost there. You can see we have only two cells left, and this one is very important. This is the one we are going to use in order to do the training. And in order to do so, you can see that we need another file, which is googlecolabconfig.yaml. Now let me show you this file. If I go to my file system and I go up, you can see I have a file which is googlecolabconfig.yaml, and if I open this file, you can see that this is a YAML file with four keys: but train ball and names. So it's very, very, very important you change this value over here, which is pat, to the location of your data in your Google Drive. You can see in my case, the data is located in my drive, Computer Vision Engineer, Object Detection, Yolov8, Google Colab, and then data. And if I go here, you can see everything is located in my drive, Computer Vision Engineer, Object Detection, Yolov8, Google Colab, and then data. But first, I also have these two folders, which are content, G drive, and this is the location of my drive in my Google Colab, right? So please pay attention and please make sure you have changed this value to whatever location you have uploaded your data to, right? This is very, very, very important. And then, if you have followed my instructions regarding how to create your dataset, how you structure your dataset, then you don't need to change anything over here, right? This is the location of your training images, this is the location of your validation images, and if you have followed my instructions, then you can just leave these two values as they are right now, right? And it's going to work just fine. Just make sure you change this path. This is very, 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 very important, and I cannot stress this enough, right? This is very, very important. And then it's the names of all the categories you are going to detect. In my case, I'm only going to detect one category, which is squirrel. So this is how it looks like for me. But please change this value to whatever object, whatever category you are going to detect in your problem. And if you are going to detect more than one object, the only thing you need to do is to do something like this, right? One is going to be your category number one, then two is going to be the category number two. This is going to be given by your data, right, by your labels. You are going to add all the categories you have in your data. In my case, it's only one, and it's squirrel. So once you have prepared this file, what you need to do is to take this file, and you're going to upload this file into your Google Drive, right? This is exactly what you need to do. The same way you did with this directory, with your data directory, you need to do it with this file. And that's pretty much all. Once everything is uploaded, you are going to get back here to your Google Colab, and now you can execute this cell. So the only thing I'm going to do now is to press enter, and I'm going to execute this cell, and that's pretty much all. That's pretty much all we need to do in order to train this object detector. The only thing we need to do now is to wait until this process is completed, and this is going to depend on how many images you are using. It's all going to depend on how many epochs you are going to train this model for. In my case, I'm going to train it for 20 epochs, and I'm using something like 2000 images, if I'm not mistaken. So this is going to take a couple of hours. I think this is going to take 2 or 3 hours, and that's pretty much all. Okay, now the training process is completed, and let me show you something. Let me show you all the output which was generated during the training process. You can see that we have a lot of information, and at the end it says results saved to, and the directory where the results were saved. So now we need to execute the last cell in this notebook, because we want to copy all the content from this directory into our Google Drive. Now it's very important you change this value over here, which is the location of your directory in your Google Drive. Please remember to change this value over here. You can see that now it says my drive, Computer Vision Engineer, Object Detection, Yolov8, Google Colab, which is the location of my directory in my Google Drive. Please remember to change this value. And once you change this value, the only thing you're going to do is to press enter, and that's pretty much all. Now let me show you my Google Drive. This is the directory I have just copied into my Google Drive. You can say it says runs, and if I open this directory, it says detect, then train, and these are all the results of the training process, right? So let me show you. Now the only thing you need to do is to download this directory. So I'm going back to here, and I am going to download like this. Okay, now we need to wait a few minutes, and that's pretty much all in order to download this directory. So this is going to download all the results you are going to use in order to evaluate this training process, and also it's going to download all the weights of the model you trained, which is very important. Let me show you super quickly. If I open this directory, runs, detect, train, then these are many plots and many images you are going to use in order to evaluate your training process. Let me show you super quickly. This is perhaps the most important of all of these plots. And then this directory, which is called weights, this is the directory which contains the model you have just trained. So this is going to be pretty much all for this tutorial. This was a very quick and a very straightforward tutorial on how to train an object detector using Yolov8. And if you have any questions regarding this process, I invite you to watch other of my previous videos where I show you the same process, but in a much more comprehensive way. I show you the entire data preparation, the entire process of how to annotate your data, how to evaluate the model you trained. This previous video is much more detailed, so I definitely invite you to take a look at this video, which I'm going to be posting over there. So this is going to be all for today. My name is Felipe. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial, and see you on my next video.